there, welcome to PrissBuzz.com. Today I'm going to show you how to create a really romantic do. This is seen on the Taylor Swift's Love Brides or Bridesmaids or New Year's or any special occasion when you have some time to set aside for your hair. So first thing I did was I put a little bit of Pureology's Anti-Fade Complex when my hair was wet. And now my hair is dry and I'm ready to go. What I'm going to be using is my Enza Milano. This is a 25mm one. You can get this at beautychoice.com. The reason why I'm using this is because the barrel is perfect, that when I release the curl, my hair is going to have that shape so that when I just pin it, it'll be ready to go. So this is a 1 inch. You can see that. The reason why I'm using the Enza Milano is it's easier. My hair slides right off and I can just pin it. And so it makes these smooth, perfect pin curls with just this thing right here. All right, so this is a little bit more complex, a little bit more difficult than other tutorials. So maybe grab pen and paper or just kind of, I'll try to go as slow as possible with this. Okay, so the first thing is you're gonna take the front part of your hair and you're going to separate it from the back. So you're gonna take like a 2 inch section for the front, and you've gotta remember that we're going to do two pieces of twists going back. So as long as you feel that there's enough, then that's fine. Then you're gonna pin this down however you need to. I'm just gonna take some bobby pins here. Hopefully this will hold. And I'll do the same thing for the other side. And this is gonna go in front of the headband. Again with the other side. My hair's kind of layered, so it's a little weird, but we're just gonna separate it. This works better with those with more hair, but since I don't have that much hair, it's okay. We're just gonna work with what we have. Again. Let's do a little X here. Oh yeah, if you're impatient, this isn't gonna work for you, but if you have patience and you wanna save $50, $60, then I totally recommend it. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna separate it in the back as well. And I like to get about a 1 inch section down here. Just kind of hold it the 1 inch as thickness-wise is what I mean, like that. And we're gonna separate it. We're gonna flip this up and get this out of our hair, out of our way, just like that. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to pin curl this, and then we're gonna just leave it on our head. This is because it can slide right down and I can pin it. So here we go. So they can be kind of messy all over the place. It doesn't have to be perfect. You're gonna take it and you're gonna wrap it around, but you're gonna wrap it in a flat motion around your curling iron. And you wanna make sure that the ends are wrapped around the heating part of it, the heating rod, so that it curls and it's nice and smooth and easy, so when you pin it up, it'll go much quicker. So then you just take it. And now you want to be really neat with this. You're going to take it. It's going to be hot, so if you can't handle the heat, this one isn't going to work for you either. So you're going to hold it down. You can always fix these later. You're going to take your bobby pin. And you're going to loop it right into the hole. And then you're going to pin it to your head again. And you're going to take another bobby pin. And you're going to loop it through the hole from the top and pin it to your scalp. It may take a couple tries, it may take a couple bobby pins, but since you're going to have one of these, and you're going to do a whole bunch in the back, and you're going to work our way to the center of our scalp right here. I'm going to do that on this side. The ones on the bottom don't have to be super perfect, just kind of get these little rolls going all over your head, is what we're working on. You're going to brush it up, make sure it's smooth. You don't have to actually use a comb, you can run your fingers through. Take this and wrap it, and you're going to wrap it flat, just like that, all the way around. The glove comes with the Enza Milano, but if you don't have a glove or if it's too hot still and you want to double up, what you can do is you can purchase one of those winter gloves and just put it on the outside. You're going to take it, and you're just going to finish the wrap, and if you want to get creative, you can kind of tilt it. Take your bobby pin, one on the bottom, all the way through. And you can even use larger bobby pins too if you need to. Make sure you don't pin your glove in. There you go. So we're just going to keep doing that. I'm going to do one over here. And you want to make sure the ends stay inside. So if it doesn't, what you can do is you just keep bobby pinning it. A little difficult with your gloves. So I'm going to redo this one here. Now if it falls out like this, you can just redo it by holding in two fingers, I recommend. Just the width of that. Wrap it all the way around. And then kind of shape it to make a circle, a little cylinder. Just like that. And then you're gonna bring this up. The ideal way is to put it through the circle. And when you go through like this, to cross it on the inside. So that would be like the optimal thing to do. But if you can't, that's fine. I've been trying to do that yourself so that you can really have those tight curls and tight wraps so that it doesn't fall out and for dancing and partying. All right, here we go. One last one on the bottom. And then work on our second row. You can see that there. I'm gonna wrap it. And then you can shape it. You can put it anywhere you want. You can take your bobby pin, same thing, right through the circle in the middle. And you're gonna pin it through. And then you're gonna stick this one through. And you wanna try to do that X if you can. All right, so let me see what it looks like in a mirror because I can't see it right now. I'm gonna do just a couple more in the middle and then I'll be right back. All right, now that you have most of it all pin curled up like this, next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna work on that top portion right here, which is a little bit more difficult. It's gonna take a little bit more time in the planning. So here it is, it's actually just hair going from one side to the other. It's a nice little half portion here. And we're gonna kind of make this curled kind of and a little more 3D, I guess, kind of pop up here a little bit. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take some from this side, doesn't matter which side, and we're gonna kind of work it and kind of frame our head. So let's do that now. Make sure you have tons and tons of bobby pins for this look and lots of time. All right, here we go. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my curling iron and I'm gonna wrap it around again flat and away from my face. And we're gonna hold it there. And release. Get this perfect little curly thing here. You're gonna take it, tuck in the ends into the little circle if you need to. And you're going to kind of wrap it, pull it back just a touch, and then pin it. You wanna make sure that the curl is nice and neat still. The ones in the back don't have to be neat. The ones in the front, you want them to be a little bit more structured. Make sure you have your bobby pins all lined up. Mine are all in this little jar here, and it's not very helpful. Okay, so I'm gonna just pin it again. We're gonna go through each of the holes and then do a little X inside. I'll keep on moving here. So I'm gonna do something, take a little bit from the back and start rolling that towards the center bun. See, I got a whole bunch here, so what you can do is you can make two rolls from this. Do this one. Everything's gonna be kind of going towards the center, kind of like sort towards the center of your bun here. The reason why I'm doing it like this right now is because I need to have my glove off because I need a little bit more control. But if you're doing this on your own and you have time, you can put the glove on, take the glove off, put it on, take it off. This top part, you're gonna make it kind of curl, and it's gonna be little curls like this. So I'm gonna have to wear my gloves for this. So I'm gonna make sure that the ends look nice and neat. I'm gonna take this first piece here, and I'm gonna do a flat curl, wrap it right around your curling iron. it's much easier to do on your own. Like, because I have to talk and kind of go through the motions. It's a little bit more difficult to haul over the place. All right, here we go. So what you're going to do is you have your little curl. You're going to kind of shape it so you can kind of see it in the front on how much hair you have. The more hair you have, the fuller this look will be. Again, you're just going to wrap it. And so for this one, I'm going to leave it like that. Just kind of make it a little messy. Not so uniform. All right, one more to go. And this one, again, is going to go towards your bun in the back. Not really a bun, though. Hold it and release it. And I'm going to just kind of roll this back up away from my face. And then I'm going to pin it. See, you're just pinning it the same way. One in the back and one on the front. Okay, now for the fun ones in the front. So I'm just going to take out these little X's here. And I'm going to flatten this down so it doesn't get in my way. So I've got the in-between bangs. So what this is going to do is kind of go like this. First thing you need, though, is a headband. Here's my little headband. And we're going to put that right behind everything, just like that. Then you're going to take these two, and you're going to go like this. First, we're going to curl it, though, so we can get everything all ready to go. So I'm going to go away from my face, because we're going to be pulling this back and twisting it. Now we're going to take it, we're going to split it, and we're just going to do a couple twists. Very soft twists, you don't want it too tight. And then you're going to discreetly pull it to the back and let it blend in with the rest of your hair. Same thing with this one. Slightly twist it, and then bring it to the back. Just pin it anywhere. Make sure your bobby pin is covered. And we're almost done. So the same thing with this side. Again, you're going to do this away from your face. Now again, you're going to do this away from your face. So I'm just going to wrap it. You're going to split it in half, and you're going to twist it the same way as the curling iron was before. And you're going to pull it back, the same thing with this one, and you're going to pull it back. Discreetly tuck it in somewhere in the back, and then you can fix it too. Just look in a mirror and get it to exactly where you want it. Now we're going to fix all those loose ones where you weren't sure how it was going to frame your face. So there's one right here that's stubborn, so I'm just going to re-roll it a little bit tighter. Okay, so then you're just going to pull some loose pieces out, recurl it if you need to. And there you go, the Taylor Swift love story hairdo. It's very simple if you have the time, you just have to concentrate on each little piece. But once you get the hang of it, it's super simple, perfect for prom and I don't know, weddings and all that good stuff. Thanks again for joining me at PurseBuzz.com, and you can get this at BeautyChoice.com. It comes with a glove, and if you need a little extra protection, you can grab another one of those winter gloves and double it up. Thanks again for joining me at PurseBuzz.com. Bye-bye.